Nice. Now we're going to go ahead and set up a document with those flowers that from the Dallas Arboretum that I had just taken out the background with the layer masking so that we have transparency. And the reason for that is because we need that in order to do this advanced text wrapping. So I'm going to go ahead and start up a new file here in InDesign. Just so you can kind of see, for those who aren't familiar with picas, I'll just go ahead and change this units to inches so you can see. I'm going to do a landscape orientation for the page at 11 inches by 8.5. And I'm just going to do the one page, just a little example of how this works. It does have some columns. I'm actually going to override, in my text box, the columns, all this. But we'll just go ahead and start this. And so with this layout, as you can see here, we've got the bleed area, which will be helpful for when, if we were going to print this. I'm going to go into File and Place. And then here's my PNG of those flowers that I'm going to put in here. And again, we had to make it a PNG so that it did preserve the transparency for those areas that we had masked. So I'm going to go ahead and double click that. I'm going to click up here. Of course, it's really huge because originally the file was. And let me just actually move this over a little bit for you so you can kind of see, so that we can tell, make sure that it is actually transparent as opposed to white, because what's showing through here is the white of the paper, or what will be paper. But if you're not sure, you can just kind of move the image around and you can see where it's gray, that actually is transparent as opposed to white. Alright, so I'm going to resize this though. I'm holding down Shift and Control. And that way it's keeping everything, the proportions the same. And do a little bit more. I do need to make sure that it does, come off of the pages the whole way. I don't want something so small that, end up losing some of the things when I go into preview. And I'm actually going to kind of like move this over. I want to get a little bit of the little flower on the right. And if you're not sure how it's going to play out, we can go in here to preview to see how it would end up kind of looking on the page. All right, so I've got most of the one and this little bit kind of popping in over on the other side. It gives a little interest there. Okay. So, I've got the image selected. Now that I've resized it for how it'll end up looking on the page. And what I'm now going to do is, in my text wrap, I'm going to choose this middle one, right? So the wrap around the object shape. But I've got to change something in here, and that is, as opposed to saying the same as clipping, which is getting, the rectangular shape, is I need to go in here to alpha channel. And what that means is it's going to detect, it'll automatically detect from the transparency of this area here that was from the Photoshop file. And I'll actually kind of bump this up just a little bit, right? So 0.625, we can play around with that in just a little bit after we place our text. So the first thing though is to set up this text wrapping for the area. Now I want to actually bring in some text. I just kind of made some silly little, some placeholder text and some info about, botany, right? And where I'm going to start my text box, I do need it within, this area here. But, I kind of want it, since I want it to sort of cradle, these contours, is I'm actually going to kind of start it right about here so that it comes into sort of this left area. I'll show you in just a second after I place it. Because I do want it to kind of come into here. Right, so I'm going to paste the text within there, and there we have it. Since we have the alpha channels set within the text wrapping on the object, it's kind of, you know, come around and curve in. You'll have to play with it just a little bit to see what you might want to change. Like if there's like an odd gap. This is where you kind of have to play a little bit with some of these different some of the different settings within your character or paragraph tabs here. So let's say like here at the bottom, right, this ing down here is kind of an odd place for it, and so I'd come into this paragraph, I'd click it within this paragraph and tell it, you know, not to hyphenate, and that way it takes it out of there. But, you know, if you want actually maybe more in there as opposed to just the ing and want to allow it to hyphenate, that's when you might want to play some with, you don't want to make things too different within all of your text, but you could do anything from, you know, well, you might even be changing your font, right? But the font size, so, you know, by being able to bring in some more text there. All right, so if you decide that you want smaller font, but of course, again, you have to kind of look at how it's splitting up words. Sometimes it, I mean, sometimes you might want something like that. I've done that where specifically playing with language in that kind of way was something I wanted. But you know, that might not be what you're going for. So if it's not, then you definitely want to kind of look at these. So it may even be that some of your paragraphs are not, you know, do not have the hyphenation, but others do, right? So that kind of depends on how you want to look. So that's the thing about going through and looking at all of it. But it also might be that you can also play some with that text wrapping. So by going back, and we'll go ahead and click on the selection tool, and we'll click on the object, and we'll go back into the text wrapping, and we can play a little bit with that to see what it does, and is that something, you know, more to our liking or less. Now it will bump it up and down in sort of prescribed increments, but you might want to change it a little bit yourself, right? So I might say 0.075, right? Because that's not one that normally comes up, and maybe that's what I would prefer. And still, you know, play around with things a little bit to see how you might want to do it. So that's where a lot of just playing around with the numbers, playing, even maybe resizing the image as well, to see what changes might occur. We don't have a whole lot of playroom with that. Or even moving it some to see, you know, how you might like that. One thing I didn't do on here, but you can, is, you know, this is again with the image selected, is I can kind of come down here and tell it to include inside edges. And so depending on how I move that around, depending on how I move the image, right? So it could actually put things within here, but again, for me, with something like this, that would be kind of oddly placed, and so I don't necessarily want that to happen. But that's something that could be done if that's of interest to you. So that's the thing, is that to kind of play around with some of this to see how the words are being set up, how they are. Moving around in this space, you know, you might decide that, you know, as opposed to having this break like this, maybe you want to fill in more within this space. It might be more difficult to tell in that sense that it is another paragraph, but that might just be how you want to work. So again, play with these things some to see how you might like that. It could even be, if you say, well, I don't necessarily like what it does to this part here, you know, since I know that is a new paragraph, I can actually move this up And remember, we can move things around with our adding these text boxes in these other spaces, right? So I can do it like that and make sure that it doesn't do this odd stuff over here. Or maybe I want to force things over to this space. So again, these are choices for you to look at and as you're kind of exploring this program as to how you might want to make it work for you. All right, so I hope that helped. Just text wrapping with your alpha channels, with the wrapping around the object shape, the alpha channel, because it is a transparent image or an image with a transparent background, and then placing that text box on top of it and letting it move around there. All right, I hope you enjoyed.